The 2023 Science and Technology Fair did not disappoint as students embarked on creating science projects to help solve life situations and fulfill human need. This year, the National School Science and Technology Fair was held under the theme Science and Technology, the Catalyst for a Brighter Tomorrow, with a host of schools participating under various categories. Addressing the closing ceremony held at the Vigi Multipurpose Sports Complex, Education Minister Honorable Sean Edward said giving school children as many avenues as possible to develop creativity in the field of science will translate to nurturing a cadre of top-level professionals within the field, making St. Lucia extremely proud.
Science is extremely important for a small island nation like St. Lucia. And I'm sure in your various classes, your teachers would have mentioned to you the range of professions you can consider, you can look at, or you can aspire to enter in that have a very solid science foundation. You can become a doctor, you can become an engineer. There are so many professions that emanate or come out of the science stream that I'm sure will excite you as young children.
The minister also paid homage and extended government's gratitude to corporate partners who continuously lend support to the National Science and Technology Fair and other activities held to promote student development. Sponsors of this year's event included Hodder Education, Computer World, the Trophy Center, Bank of St. Lucia, and the St. Lucia Electricity Services Limited, Lucilec.
The government of St. Lucia, or the Ministry of Finance more specifically, can never have enough resources or money to give to the Ministry of Education to cause us to roll out programs for the education of our children. And so there have been times when we go to the private sector and business houses and we say to them, look, we need your assistance, we need you to partner us to achieve this particular objective. And very often, the business community has always come to the aid of the ministry to make events or activities like the science fair possible.
The projects produced by students depicted various themes including environmental, science and technology, agriculture, and mathematics games. They were judged in several categories, namely infant, primary, lower secondary, and tertiary levels. In the end, out of the 36 entries, it was the Deriso Primary School who was named overall winner, having also won the primary category to the environmental theme. Curriculum Officer for Science and Technology, Claudius Attil, says the projects produced by students are becoming more and more innovative with each hosting of the activity.
Our students' science projects have sparked many small businesses over the years. So we are not saying, students, that your project will end here. We are tasking you with using your resources, using your businesses around you, using our partners, and taking our project from this point, and let us see how far we can go.
The VA4 infant was judged winner of the infant level, whilst the Stanley John Odlum Memorial Secondary School won the lower secondary school category, and the VA4 Comprehensive Secondary became the victors of the tertiary level competition. In special awards given, the Dame Paulette Louise Primary was awarded the Motilal Singh Top Science and Technology Award and the Top Study Award, while the Deriso Primary received the awards for Innovation and the Alan Gabriel Top Environmental Project. The Fosse Jacques Primary was awarded the prize for Top Mathematics Games. From the Communications Unit of the Ministry of Education, Sustainable Development, Innovation, Science, Technology and Vocational Training, I am Chris Satney, reporting.